Hello friends, myself Vikas Shakya, and today I'm going to discuss about the mutex kernel object in this series of Windows programming. So as the name suggests, the mutex means mutual exclusion, which means no two threads can access the same resource at the same time. If you have this kind of scenario where you have to stop these things, like two threads from two different applications, they should not access the same resource at the same time, then in that case you can use the mutexes, right? So let us start with the code and let's create some application using the mutex. And the application will be like launch only one instance of the application using mutex. This is what we are going to do as a basic mutex operation understanding, like how the mutex works, right? And apart from that, before I start, let's just quickly go through this recursion counter. What is the meaning of recursion counter? Recursion counter is a property of the kernel object, mutex kernel object, which says that, which records that at as how many times a thread has acquired the mutex kernel object, right? I have already told you in one of my previous videos that every kernel object has one state, which is called the signaled or the non-signaled state. Signaled state means the kernel object is available to acquire, and the non-signaled state means that the kernel object is not available, which means that some other thread has acquired it, okay? So let's go to the application. So I have created a handle here for the mutex, and let's quickly create the mutex. So h mutex is equal to create mutex, and here I will just pass null, and then what is there, initial owner. I will tell you about this initial owner things later. As of now, let's make it false, and then let's do one thing here. I need to give the name of the mutex, so it's text. And here you need to give the name M1. I'm just giving the name as M1 for this mutex kernel object. And then I have told you that for any kind of kernel object, you need to call this get last error function, right? So call this get last error. And if error is not equal to 0 and error is not equal to error already exists, then in that case, ENDL, you just need to write the mutex initialization failed and just return it from here. Return exit failure. Right? So I hope you understand that what is this mean? What does this mean? Error already exists will come if someone else has already created this mutex kernel object with the same name. Okay, I will show you in some other video, or you can do it yourself. Just create the mutex for the first time and check the error code. It will come as zero, and stop in that application, and meanwhile launch the other application using the same mutex. Then in that case, you will get this thing: error already exists, and this is not a bug. This is not a problem. Right, because one mutex kernel object can be shared by many, and that is the purpose of the kernel objects, right? So that everyone can wait on that one, and then it can just move ahead once the object is signaled, right? So that is the purpose. So here what I'm going to show you, like how you can stop one application to launch two instances. What does this mean? That suppose if you have app.exe, and if you double click on the app.exe for the first time, then the application will launch and it will be running there till you close it. But if you run the same exe again, then in that case, it should show you that the other instance of the same application is running and you cannot run this application. So these kind of things you may need to implement in your career most of the times, because these kind of requirements usually comes, like only one instance of an application is needed to execute, not the second instance. So for such cases, we can use the mutex kernel object. Okay, so let me just do one thing. Here I just want to wait on the kernel object, right? So I will just call the wait for single object. Right here, I will just give the name of the mutex's handle, which is at mutex, and here I will wait infinitely. Right, so this is infinite. This is waiting infinitely. So since we are waiting for this first time, waiting on this mutex for the first time. So it means that this mutex kernel object has not been acquired by anyone. This is the first thread which is acquiring it. So what will happen that this thread will be able to acquire the mutex. And at the same time, it will set the state of the mutex as non-signal, right? Which means that if any other thread will try to acquire the same mutex kernel object, then in that case, that particular thread in that particular application will not be able to acquire this, right? So let me just elaborate it because it is very confusing. So this function call, let me just explain it. This function call will make the, will acquire the kernel object, mutex kernel object, mutex kernel object, if it is signal. But if not signal, then it will wait till the time is specified. And if it is acquired by the thread, then after acquiring it, it will not, it will make it non-signal at the same time. Which means that no other thread can now acquire it, right? So I'm just doing the spelling mistake. Somehow it happens like when I'm typing on the keyboard, my fingers are very, you know, they are not that fat. My fingers are not that fat. But when I type on the keyboard, somehow these fingers becomes like the foot of the elephant. At the same time, I press lot many keys. I'm not sure what is this, what law of Newton applies on this kind of absurd things, but this is what happens. So jokes apart, but that really makes my life miserable when I'm doing something like this to record something for you. Anyways, just leave that dirty thing. So here it's wait for single object, and here we are waiting it here for infinitely, and we are just going to do something like this: wait failed, if it is wait failed, or dw is equal to wait abandoned, or dw is equal to wait timeout. So if any of these values comes, then it means that we have the problem in the wait function. So in that case, what we will do, the wait failed, and just return it from here because this is a complete failure. Okay, so this is what is happening here. And now what we will do here, if my application is acquired the mutex kernel object, then in that case it will simply print a message, cout endl app is running, and press any key to get this closed. So get char. Okay, so after that I need to write like this release mutex. So if you have pressed any key and your application is application comes to an end, then in that case you need to release the mutex so that anyone else who is waiting on that mutex kernel object should be able to acquire it. Okay, and if you want, you can just close it, close handle. So you have just closed it here. So this is my application. I'm just going to build it. So what will happen as of now, since I'm waiting here infinitely, so what will happen if first application instance will be launched, then in that case you will be able to see this message. But even when you will launch the second instance of the same application, then in that case this wait for single object function will stop that thread at this place. It will keep waiting until this get char, which means that until you press the key, this release mutex and this close handle will not be called. And since this release mutex will not be called till then, so till then that will be waiting, the other thread will be waiting. Once you will press any key and this release mutex will be called, then in that case what will happen, that the other thread which was waiting on the thread, which was waiting on the mutex kernel object, will move ahead from there, and that will also print this message. So let me just show you that how it will happen. So let's go to the application. So this is my application, which is an x64 application. So I need to come here, I just need to copy here, I need to open two command prompts so that I can show you the working of this application. So this is where I'm just typing it, and then cmd, and I just need to go to there, and these are the two windows. And now I will just run it here, my application, which is arrayExample.exe. So app is running, and press any key to get this close. So you can see that when I first run that application, then in that case it was able to acquire this mutex kernel object, because no one else was using it, so it was able to acquire it, and it printed this message: app is running and press any key to get this closed, right? Now if I run this second application, then what will happen? Oh god, rather than tab I pressed some other key. Okay, so here you can see it is waiting there, it is not printing anything. App is run, just like it is printing app is running and press any key to get this closed, but this is waiting here. Why? Because this is running, and till this is running, this mutex will not be released. And once this mutex will be released after you press the enter key or any key, then in that case what will happen, that after releasing the mutex, the other application which is waiting here on the wait for single object, that will be able to acquire the object, because after calling the release mutex, that mutex kernel object will be signaled, right? So let's see what happens. So I'm just going to press the key, I just press the key, it is closed, and now let's see what happens. So here you can see that it is now showing that app is running and press any key to get this closed, right? So it was waiting there. But our main purpose was the launch only one instance of the application using mutex, which means that we should not launch the other instance of the application. I mean, if the other application has been launched, if the other instance gets launched, then in that case it should show the message that other instance of the application is already running. So we will do a slight change here. I will simply do one thing here. I will just pass zero. Zero means I will just check the availability of the mutex kernel object, and if it is not available, then I will get this wait failed. And since I will get wait failed, which means that other application is already using it. So let me just do a small change here, and let's make this wait failed. And here I will just print the message: cout endl, the application one instance is already running, right? Return exit failure. One instance of the application is already running, and then you need to just return from here, because wait will fail, because we have just provided a zero, we have not provided it infinite. Because infinite means that I will wait till someone else releases the mutex, but here I will not wait, I will simply just check whether this is available or not. So this time when I will run this application for the first time, then it will show you this message. If I run the second instance, okay, let me just compile it. I think I have not compiled it, and that is what the problem is. So let me just close it, let me just close this one, and let me again compile it, and let's run it again. So this is here and this is here. So the weight failed. It says that the weight failed because no, it's not here. It should be wait timeout. Sorry, it was not wait failed. It should be timeout because it's 0 seconds. So it should be timeout. So let me just rebuild it again. And now it should be working fine. Oh God. I just build it without closing it. Okay, so let me just run it again. And let me just run it again. And this time it shows that one instance of the application is already running and that's why it's closed. Right, so let me just press here and close this one as well. So this is what happens when you use the mutex kernel object. This is one of the basic example of using the mutex kernel object. Right now there are many things which I need to discuss about the mutex kernel objects, but the video will become longer. So I'm just closing it for today. And in the next video, we will discuss about the concept of the recursion counter and the ownership. Here I have passed false. We will see that what will happen if I pass the true. Okay, so in the next video, we will discuss two things. Recursion counter and the ownership of mutex. These two things we will see in the next video. So till then, have a nice day and bye-bye.